We take you now to BBC in England.
And as his trusty little donkey carried Quixote up the road, he could see the gates of the city ahead. Don Quixote's excitement rose as he contemplated the knightly adventures that awaited him. I see our time is running out, and there we leave Don Quixote sitting on his ass until tomorrow at the same time.
Stay tuned as we bring you another in the intriguing radio series, Mr. Keen, Tracer of Lost Persons.
We now bring you Mr. Keen, Loser of Traced Persons.
Boners are not always committed by performers. Sound effects men, too, have their share of woe. Let's listen to this dramatic show, which was popular in the early days of radio.
Okay, you rat. I got you covered, and now I'm going to drill you. Take that! Okay, now I'm really going to drill you. Take that! On second thought, I'm going to take this knife and slit your throat.
On a program which originated from the Great Lakes Naval Station, Eddie Peabody, the great banjoist, was introduced thusly.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eddie Playbody will now pee for you.
Let's listen to this newscaster's exciting report of an important wedding.
All the world was thrilled with the marriage of the Duke and Duchess of Windsor.
Performers on an all-night telethon can get very tired. Let's listen to Maury Amsterdam doing his bit for a worthy cause.
We'll be able to give you a report on how much money we took in just a few moments. Oh, here's a note that was just handed to me. Mr. and Mrs. John Gielgud of the Bronx sent in $2. Oh, there's a note here. Tell Teresa to go to bed. All right, Teresa will go to bed for $2. Oh, sorry.
Here's what comes of making poor, hard-working announcers get up early in the morning. It happened in the days when the National Broadcasting Company was comprised of the Red Network and the Blue Network, now the American Broadcasting Company. Their facilities were combined in Radio City, New York. One morning, a bleary-eyed announcer dashed into the studio just as he was to deliver his station break. Pressing the monitor button, he declared to the world,
"This is either the Red Network or the Blue Network of the National Broadcasting Company."
An extra was carried away by the honesty of Abe Lincoln on a television play, one which Raymond Massey starred as Abe Lincoln. As Lincoln's well-wishers were bidding him a fond farewell, the extra's voice was heard above the goodbyes of the milling throng.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr.
Massey. An announcer picked up a script one day and read it exactly as it was handed to him. It was a bull of a commercial, the Standard Time signal, with some additions to be made at appropriate times. Here is what the listeners heard.
It's 8 p.m., bull of a watch time. On Christmas, say Merry Christmas. On New Year, say Happy New Year.
Thank you, Mamie. That was fine, fine. And now Cecil Gill, a yodeling country boy, will sing There's an Empty Bunk in the Cat House Tonight. There's an empty cot in the bunkhouse tonight.
So, friends, don't forget to visit your A and Poo feed store.
Performers are not always responsible for the boners that you hear in radio and television. Continuity writers are very often the culprits, as evidenced by this classic bit of writing.
Steinberg's department store has just received a shipment of large-size bathing suits. Ladies, now you can buy a bathing suit for a ridiculous figure.
A local Midwest station told its citizens about the prize winners of their annual farm contest.
And here they are. Final results of the FFA contest are: apple picking won by Dick Jones, tractor driving award to Jack Davis, and one of our own girls, Miss Betty Smith, was chosen as the best whore.
New Year's Eve found this announcer in a jovial mood.
This is WJZ New York. No other station can make that statement.
Good morning, ladies. I'm awfully glad you're with us this morning because we have a very special recipe that we want you to be sure and prepare over the weekend. It's something that I'm sure will surprise your husband, and it's called a frickin' chickasee. Oh, I beg your pardon. That's chicken fricassee.
We're here at Washington's National Airport awaiting the arrival of our very distinguished guests, the King and Queen of England. When they arrive, you will hear a 21-sun galoot.
This is Indiana's first broadchasing station.
A program director of a Texas station finished preparing the day's schedule. Later, he made a change. Instead of Les Brown's orchestra, he substituted a religious program which was to originate from New York. He scratched out Les Brown's name and wrote over it Yom Kippur. When the new announcer came on shift, he picked up the schedule and exhorted his listeners to
stay tuned for the dance music of Yom Kippur's orchestra.
Let's switch our dials to a daytime program presided over by your friendly homemaker.
Now we present our homely friendmaker.
Sometimes an announcer has to rush to beat the second hand around the clock. This announcer hurriedly finished a religious program to be in time for a station break.
And be sure to listen next week when the topic of the sermon will be Cast Thy Broad Upon the Waters. This is the National Broadcasting Company.
We take you to Monmouth Racetrack in Monmouth, New Jersey.
Well, now, just before we get down to the feature race, it looks very much today, in the opinion of the experts, that it's going to be a very, very close contest between Dolly Jane and that beautiful new bay, Harass. Now, just a minute, fans. I've noticed here that Harass is not going to run. Remember now, Harass is not going to run. Be sure to scratch Harass.
Go to your neighborhood theater to see Rita... Yeah. Go to your neighborhood theater to see Rita Hayworth, whose salami will take your breath away.
Hey, that's salami, you jerk.
Everyone in your family will love Manischewitz wine. Sweet, but not too sweet. Tangy, just right. Get Manischewitz wine, WABD, New York.
Ladies, does your husband wake up in the morning feeling lustless, listless?
Here's a wartime OPA message urging housewives to conserve valuable fats.
Ladies, take your fat cans down to the corner butcher.
It's reported that the collision of the freighters was due to the fog, which was as thick as sea poop.
I'd like to dedicate my next number to my good friend Henry and his expectant bride.
Newsmen also have their sense of humor, as evidenced by the complete breakup of this newscaster.
In the wonder world of science, the Hayden Planetarium has heard from a Minnesota man who claims that the shape of Aurora Borealis, the northern lights, can be changed by flapping a bedsheet at them from the ground. The planetarium doubts it, but the man says he did successfully flap sheets in his backyard one midnight, though his wife kept hollering at him to cut out the foolishness and get back in the house. Now here are today's closing Dow Jones stock averages. Industrials off 14 cents, rails up 3 cents, utilities up 7 cents. And that's today's Headline Edition.
Tune in tomorrow at this same time for Headline Edition. You'll hear important reports of the names who made the news in vivid honesty. This Sunday evening, be sure and hear Drew Pearson on ABC. Pearson has received many awards for his work, and one of his treasures is the Saturday Review of Literature site. This is ABC, the American Broadcast.
Vice President Humphrey got a boost for a new job today. Senator George McGovern, Democrat of South Dakota, says the Vice President would be a good man to head a worldwide war on Hungary. Or rather, hunger.
We take you now to BBC in England, where a children's show is in progress.
We're going to play a hiding and finding game with music. Now, this is what we do. We pretend that you've got some balls, and I'm going to hide them. They might be hidden high up near the ceiling. Or they might be hidden low down on the floor. You don't know where I'm going to hide your balls, but the music will tell you. Now, first of all, shut your eyes while I hide them. Yes, shut your eyes. Now, open your eyes and dance lightly about looking everywhere for your balls. And now the music's going to tell you where your balls are. They may be high up so that you have to stretch and jump up for them, or they may be low down so that you have to pick them up off the floor. Listen. Well, were your balls high up or low down? They were high up, and I hope you've all jumped up and got them. Now, dance round and toss them in the air and play with them.
Don't forget to give your girl a gorgeous screw-in for Christmas.
On an audience participation show, Herb Schreiner, the popular Indiana Hoosier, asked a woman if she were a natural-born citizen of the United States.
Oh, no, I was born cesarean.
Evening Melodies is heard 1 hour earlier if your community is on Eastern Standard Time, 1 hour later if, well, there is a 2-hour difference in certain cities that, oh, to hell with it.
Out of the mouths of babes, oft time come gems. Let's tune in on the airwaves' brightest children's program.
And now, kids, it's back to Buffalo Bob and Howdy Doody time.
What's your name, little fella?
Kenneth.
How old are you, Kenneth?
Five.
Five. Kenny, did you ever do anything wrong?
We farted.
I see. And you think they should get the spanking then, huh?
No.
Okay. Thank you very much, little fella. And what's your name?
Teddy.
And how old are you, Teddy?
Six.
And did you ever do anything wrong?
I forgot what I did wrong.
Come over, Mr. Cobb. Talk to the boys a minute.
What happened, Buffalo?
His name is Teddy.
And now stay tuned for I Love Loosely. Here's a news item about the Russians that once again crapped up in the news.
On Strike It Rich, popular television program, the master of ceremonies interviewed a 5-year-old child whose father was in the U.S. Army serving in Korea. The child wanted to strike it rich for a new bed and a larger apartment. Let's listen in to the child's problem.
My daddy is in the Army in Korea. When my Uncle Charlie comes over the weekends, he makes me sleep in the kitchen. But he's really not my Uncle Charlie.
One of radio's dependable and veteran announcers came out with this classic.
The Soviet Union today launched a new multi-seat spaceship with 3 cosmonauts aboard. TASS, the official Soviet news agency, reported that the spaceship Vostok carried a pilot, a scientist, and a doctor. The agency, which gave no hint of how long the space trio would stay aloft, said the flight was being made to carry out scientific, physical, and technical investigations of a space flight and to continue to study the effects of different factors of space flight on man's orgasms. The spaceship... Hello? Hello, New York.
A copywriter who confused a shoe commercial with a watch commercial made this announcer his unfortunate victim.
9 p.m. BULOVA, Bulova Watch Time.
This Christmas, buy her the new Bulova President. Curved to fit the foot.
Curved to fit the foot? Huh?
The Overhead Door Company has the finest in garage doors and is currently having its semi-annual sale. Hurry in now for the best selection. But remember, this special on homeowners, the type garage door ends Saturday at 5 p.m. at the Overhead Door Company. That should be the Overhead Door Company.
Two youthful bandits made a clean getaway in today's daring daylight robbery. The robbers cleaned out two girl tellers' drawers. That is, the money drawers.
Tonight, your city station brings you a summertime treat. We take you to Central Park Mall for an appalling program of band music. I meant appealing.
Here's an incident from the popular Share the Wealth program of a few years ago.
All right, now here's your next chance to share the wealth. Now, this next series of questions pertains to animals and history. You got that? In each case, who had an association with an animal. Now, young lady, it's your turn. Now, where'd you say we're from again, young lady?
Brooklyn.
All right, Brooklyn. Now, well, we're going to go way back to English history for you.
Oh,
now, what animal do you associate with Lady Godiva?
Thayer. Oh, air!
That was the latest national and international news direct from the wires of the Associated Press. And now for an item on the lighter side. Hollywood. Jane Russell's husband, Bob Waterfield, was reported to have said in a recent interview, "I don't want her to do either housework or cooking. I don't want her to endanger her career by bending over a hot stove." And that's the news.
Tune in now to Ringside, where an exciting fight is in progress.
What an action-packed round that was! 3 minutes of thrilling excitement. While we're waiting for round four, fans, how about joining me in a glass of Pabst Blue Ribbon beer?
With this handy automatic dishwasher, all you have to do is twist a button and push a lever. I beg your pardon. Push a button and twist a lever.
On a popular program on which occupations are guessed, the contestant was a mattress stuffer. One of the panelists asked this.
Is your product used by one sex over another?
Here's a brief extract from a ringside interview with a wrestler.
Well, I tell you, I was out in Las Vegas one time, and I wrestled this guy. He's about 220 pounds. I threw the bum right out of the ring.
How many fights did you have? How many matches, actually?
Oh, I had quite a few. I must have had around 97 or 98.
No kidding. Did you win them all?
I won most of them. I wrestled 60 matches without any draws.
Theme saying, "I'm confessing," and we were all expecting all of the policemen to come out and start beating him with a rubber hose.
I don't wonder. Walter Winchell was there, huh?
Yes,
peeking through keyholes.
No, he wasn't peeking through keyholes.
That's his racket, though.
Really?
Yeah, they say he looked through a keyhole one time. Come on, everybody. Some news for you folks. This is a live show. No tape.
Shall we go on?
What are my wife and four children going to do with my mother?
I was going to say, then of course the next morning... riding and swimming, the nook. say now.
Wonderful. Howard Blake keeps saying, let's go, Bill. Come on, we got to move the show. He doesn't know I fainted. Roberta, thank you, dear.
You're very
fabulous weekend. David. Dave, come out here, will you? I don't want to appear too curious, but what...
I don't either.
What are you... We're all going to jail together, is that the
Everybody.
Idea?
Everybody.
What do you have in the folder,
You're afraid to ask, huh? Well, I'll tell you, I hate to go through all this right now.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
Take the heck with it.
Well, outside of my pink slip, what do you have in the folder there?
Well, I'll tell you, that's just, this is just some stuff. You know, I have a collection. There's a lady with a collection, too. We have a collection, you see. How do you spell keyhole? No, seriously, I have to go through this because we may never get off the air otherwise.
Dave, is it true that you have traveled 250,000 miles around the world entertaining our troops overseas and everything?
That's right.
That's right, isn't it?
That's right.
You want to leave right after the show? Because I'm going with you.
The microphone is a sensitive instrument and can be dangerous. Listen to this female announcer who forgot that the microphone was listening.
And now, audience, here is our special TV matinee guest that we've all been waiting for. World-famous author, lecturer, and world traveler, and man about town, what the hell is his name?
When you're thinking of an all-season thirst quencher, it's a delight, winter or summer. Instant White Rose, hot or cold, orange, Tico P.
Many advertising agencies mark their scripts to show which points to emphasize. Listen to this nervous novice announcer doing his first commercial.
Collins bread is slow baked. Punch this. That means that, make this sincere, every inch of each loaf is evenly browned, making for delicious, wholesome, super digestible bread. When your grocer asks you, emphasize this, be sure you say, Collins bread.
And now, a medley of tunes from Walt Disney films. Hi Diddledy Dee, When You Wish Upon a Star, and I've Seen Everything When I See an Elephant's Fly.
Our Homes and Garden show was represented by Mrs. Browning, who was at the flower show with her twin daughters, Alice, age 6, and Audrey, age 9.
We take you now to a musical program broadcast by the BBC in London.
Here's an all-time favorite made popular by the famous Miss Jessie Matthews several years back, Dancing on the Ceiling. This one surely deserves to be on every British shit list.
And on the lighter side, it seems that streaking is still a popular pastime. This time at a local football game just outside of Boston. I can't for the life of me figure out this type of behavior. I guess it's their way of showing their nuts.
Good afternoon. This is your daily weather forecaster bringing you up-to-the-minute weather news direct from the municipal airport. Word has just reached us that a southeast girl blowing at about 70 miles an hour is reported on her way.
Listen to an incident from one of your favorite cowboy adventure programs.
He come high-tailing out of that saloon like a coyote come howling out of a canyon. But the varmint didn't get away. He got his foot caught in the syrup.
Here's an old favorite. Tenor with organ, looking for a girl named Sally.
Anyone can be responsible for a blooper. And to prove the point, here's one that came from the typewriter of a continuity writer.
Ladies, before we bring you our new Gene Autry record, here's a word from our new sponsor, the Smith Laundry. I mean, you may have had problems with your husband's shirts or different kinds of underwear. Where it comes from the laundry torn by machinery, well, you won't have that trouble because we do it carefully by hand.
At the launching of a ship in Norway, a local announcer with a fine Oxford accent but not too good a grasp of English was doing the shortwave broadcast when this occurred.
The Duchess handled the launching beautifully, smashing the champagne bottle against the prow with the aplomb of an expert. The crowd cheered as she slipped majestically down the greasy runway into the sea.
Here's another handy service from your Tintex dealer. Just stop in at any dealer who handles Tintex, and he will give you a free demonstration telling you how to dye in your washing machine.
We take you now to Rochester for the National Open Golf Tourney.
Well, sports fans, Cary Middlecoff has done it again. With a one-stroke win over veteran Ben Hogan, the golf world has a new opium champion.
WIOD salutes the world's largest Oldsmobile dealer. It's a Bob and Ray thing.
Now, you've just heard the front side of Doris Day's latest hit, Secret Love. Let's take a look at her backside. That is, her other side.
When a station carries two programs, one local and one network, the crossing of the two lines can bring unexpected effects. Listen to this.
The recipe this afternoon is for potato pancakes. I'm sure you'll all enjoy them. You take six medium-sized potatoes, one onion, one egg, pepper and salt, and then you fry them in deep fat, and I'm sure your guests will just love them.
Funeral services will be held promptly at 2 o'clock.
We're mighty proud of these 4-H clubs. The work they do throughout the country is something that makes every farm man proud to know his boys are growing up, know how to handle the things that you have to handle here on the farms. Now, Bill Jorgen, for your work in sanitation and hygienics, I'm proud to present this plague to you.
We tune in now to a United Nations news summary.
The conference at the UN regarding the Russian proposal is expected to come to a successful conclusion at the end of this session.
Contestants on audience participation programs are often nervous and sometimes give strange answers.
Now, this shouldn't be too hard. Here it is. All I want you to do is to give me the names of three of Santa's reindeer. Now, just think back to the poem The Night Before Christmas and give me just three of the reindeer's names.
There was Prancer.
That's right.
And Dancer.
Good, that's two. Only one more. Prancer and Dancer and
Blunces.
The entire crew of the bomber thought they had completed the mission unscathed, but on the way back from Korea, the super fart burst into flame.
Hello, darlings. This is Tallulah Bankhead. You know, I read something recently that made me very happy. Hopeful is a better word. Let me quote a heart authority from the Mayo Clinic. He said, within the lifetime of physicians now living, there will be no heart disease which cannot be prevented or corrected, unquote. He goes on to say, oh, shit.
Here's an incident from a man on the street quiz show.
Now, Mr. Esposito, are you ready for your second question?
That's all right.
Your category is bodies of water. Tell me, where would you find the Great Lakes?
The Great Lakes. Upper U.S.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this news bulletin to bring you a program.
Our late show film presentation for this evening will be a revival featuring the late Leslie Howard as the Scarlet Pimple. I'm sorry, I mean the Scarlet Pimpernel.
Let's listen to this commercial for a self-service laundry.
Ladies who care to drive by and drop off their clothes will receive prompt attention.
And the Midwest is suffering from one of its worst winters in history, with temperatures dropping to 22 degrees below zero. Tomorrow's forecast is for continued mild.
You got a souvenir?
I got a souvenir.
What is it?
It's, I don't know. It's what's a peace demonstrator's flag. Says peace in Vietnam, we won't fight. You know what they're going to do with it? You ever see a guy wipe his ass with it?
Tune in again tomorrow, same time, same station, to see if John will goose Sadie's cook. That should read, to see if John cooks Sadie's goose.
Even the most veteran performers sometimes burst into uncontrollable laughter when something strikes them funny, as evidenced by Lowell Thomas's complete breakup while he was doing a newscast.
And the little girl deserves to know her mother. So says Alice, and I think her mother deserves to know her. Well, Alice also has to keep her husband. Phil Harris, the band leader, she explains that working so hard all day in the film studio, she is sometimes not in such perfectly good humor. And she snaps at hubby. Which is all wrong. Which I say, you're all for Alice. And I'll leave the rest of it to you.
Well, tomorrow's the 1st of May. Now Lowell Thomas says,
so long until tomorrow.
This program came to you from New York.
And now we are going to hear a recording of Rimsky-Korsakov's Bum of the Flightful Bee.
Stay tuned now for a dramatization of Dickens' immortal Tale of Two Cities. Tales of Two Cities.
Children on audience participation programs are certainly unpredictable. As an example, let's listen to a kid's show of a few years ago known as Make-A-Wish.
Now, Marion, if you had your wish, what would you want most?
I want to go to the toilet.
Police in Danvers this morning discovered a half-nude body of a man lodged in a sewer pipe. Although not believed to be connected to the current rash of gangland slayings, police have termed the death a suicide.
In the dictionary, you will find a word pronounced peon, spelled P-A-E-A-N. It means to praise. However, an ice cream sponsor didn't endorse this announcer's choice of words.
And now is a good time to pee on Brody's ice cream.
On Two for the Money, popular TV program, a young lady was asked about her occupation.
I work for the Pittsburgh Natural Gas Company. Over 90% of the people in Pittsburgh have gas.
National Safety Week got off to a bad start today when the cook in Charlie's Diner accidentally laid his hand on a hot griddle.
Merton Marge, one of radio's most beloved programs, had a character known as Myrtle Hayfield until an actor accidentally got her name slightly fouled up.
You're just a feel, Myrtle Hayfool.
And now, here's a full story on the Russian freighter that capsized in Portland's harbor this afternoon.
And now our pianist is going to tear off a piece named Margie.
I see we're ready for our next sidewalk interview on the Man in the Street program, and it's a young lady in uniform. Miss, your name, please?
Rose Palmer.
And where are you from, Miss Palmer?
Phoenix, Arizona.
I see. And tell me, are you a whack or are you a wave?
Can't you tell by looking at my uniform?
Well, you see, we have a large listening audience, and they can't tell. Of course, from where I'm standing, I can see your navel.
On the smaller radio stations throughout the country, the announcer often doubles as engineer, announcer, producer, director. Let's hear the result of this one-man staff decision to drop the needle on a transcription, depart from the studio for a 15-minute break for a cup of coffee.
Remember, friends, this is the big holiday weekend coming up, so don't be caught short by unexpected guests. Go to your A&P, and P, and P, and P.
The one thing in radio and television that never changes is time. The clock on the wall won't wait for anybody. You have to start your show on time and finish your show on time. When you are running late, things like this are bound to happen.
It's a 9-pound boy born at Memorial Hospital for Mr. and Mrs. Jack Jason of Elm Road. Mrs. Jason was the former Susan Mulhaney of Sudbury. Services will be held tomorrow at 2 p.m. at Morton's Funeral Chapel for Jasper Howard, age 91, who passed on in his sleep yesterday. Our time is running out, So several deaths and births will have to be postponed until next week at the same time.
So be among the many who change over to mild-tasting Philly cigars. Remember, all the fellas are switching to fellas. I mean, Phillies.
All right, young lady, now here we go for the giant jackpot question. Now, this is going to be very important to you, and if you get it, you may win. You just may walk home with all the prizes tonight. Now, listen very carefully. This is important to you. Tell me, what is the Taj Mahal?
I'm afraid I don't know.
Oh, I'm awfully sorry, but you should know that the Taj Mahal, located in India, is the greatest erection man has ever had for woman since time immemorial.
On his recent visit to the United States, Emperor Haile Selassie of Ethiopia made an eloquent plea for peace.
And that is why we are proud that our company is the largest producer in the United States of magnesium, aluminum, and steel.
On a famous husband and wife morning show, which had several breakfast foods as sponsors, the following was heard.
What did you have for breakfast, son? Well, what did you have for breakfast, son? Sonny, what did you have for breakfast?
Ouch, Daddy, you're hurting my arm.
Hogan steps up to the tee. There's a rather strong crosswind blowing from the left. He addresses the ball, and oh, that tee shot was beautiful. It carried about 130 miles from the green.
On an audience participation program, the master of ceremonies asked a veteran sea captain who was on this day celebrating his birthday how it felt to be 90 years old.
Topside him all right, but below the waterline, I ain't worth a damn.
As I look out the window, I hesitate to say that it's raining, because the Weather Bureau doesn't call it that. They call it fog. This is to tell you that the fog is overflowing the sewers. And the weatherman down at the Battery here in New York says the forecast for today is clear. Well, I just got here after a 40-minute train delay, and all I can say is that the snow is clear up to my ass ankles.
Poor timing and improper pauses can be the source of many a headache for announcers, as evidenced by this improper change of pace.
And the United Nations will adjourn until next week. And now here's a local news item. A lot of villagers were very startled today when a pack of dogs broke loose from a dog catcher's wagon, and then they raced crazily through the fields of a well-known tobacco plantation. Friends, does your cigarette taste different lately?
A CBS performer, while doing a program on etiquette, instructed her audience as to the proper way to set a table.
And according to proper etiquette, you should set the table in this manner. Place the sports and foons on the table. The porks and spoons. Of course, you know I mean the sporks and spoons.
On a program on which Art Linkletter was MC, a little girl was asked what her mother had told her not to say on the radio that day.
My mother told me not to announce on the radio that she was pregnant.
Now our next contestant, that's Mrs. Florence Kinsey from...
From Providence, Rhode Island.
Providence, Rhode Island. Tell me, Mrs. Kinsey, are you any relation to the Dr. Kinsey?
Not that I know of.
Well, have you read the Kinsey Report?
No, I'm waiting for them to make it into a movie.
Now, Sally, you've won $32. Are you ready now? Here we go for the $64 question.
The $64 question has been the trademark of Take It or Leave It, one of broadcasting's most popular quiz shows. The sailor was asked to name a noisy food like celery. Let's listen to his classic answer.
Beans.
Here's a news item about a prize dog. Let's listen to this newscaster's personal comment at the conclusion of the story.
And now, finally in the news, a story that came in over our wires a little while ago. That prize-winning dog of Madison Square Garden was crated and shipped from New York City to Boston the other day. It seemed that the valued dog got his tail caught in the crate. The tail apparently was removed, and the irate owner sued for $10,000 in damages. That's a lot of money for a piece of tail.
Let's tune in on this disc jockey, who was sponsored by a new housing development.
At the Quaker Housing Development, we have just one house left. Now, you better hurry, as we're pretty sure this one won't last long. And now for our record. It's just an old shanty in old shanty town.
On Queen for a Day, an 8-year-old boy wanted to win a brand new suit. When asked why, this is what the youngster had to say.
I want to wear it tomorrow when my mommy and daddy get married.
Now, briefly recrapping the news on Capitol Hill, G.O. Lee Peters. Now, briefly recrapping the news on Capitol Hill, G.O. Lee Peters.
This incident occurred on the College of Musical Knowledge, widely heard musical and audience participation program. The master of ceremonies was surprised that a lady contestant, young in appearance, had 9 children. He asked what her husband did.
Oh, my husband operates an automatic screwing machine.
World-famous Lowell Thomas, one of the airwaves' best-known commentators, has a sense of humor which is sometimes uncontrollable.
President Eisenhower today visited the Chocolate City. The president driving into Hershey, Pennsylvania to celebrate his 63rd birthday. 30,000 or more people were cheering him, all the folks who make Hershey chocolate with and without nuts. Fred Waring was on hand to conduct a chorus of 1,800. Ben Hogan to give an exhibition on how he drives a golf ball. And that was a special interest to our shopping president. A demonstration like that famous Ben Hogan power golf.
Well, Lowell, I won't putter around with that one. Instead, I'll tee off with a tip to those car buyers who like to drive a hard bargain. Now your local Kaiser and Henry J. dealer wants you to know about the new low Henry J. price. Only $1,399 plus rate and local taxes. And that means the lowest down payment, lowest monthly payments on any new car. In fact, after down payment, you can own a new Henry J. for less than $10 a week. And I'll need $10 a week from now on, so come on in tomorrow.
Let's listen to this sportscaster's description of a football team's ace kicker.
The score at the half remained 6-6, but during the third quarter, the Crimson really came to life, scoring a touchdown on 8 successive plays. The turning point came when the coach sent in his ass picker. Ass passer. ace passer.
And don't forget to go to your neighborhood theater and see To Hell and Back, starring Audie Murphy, World War II hero and battle-scared veteran.
The word indigent means poor or needy. Listen to what happened to this baseball manager who was plugging the all-star baseball game.
So, we urge you to show up. Because if you want to see some of the greatest pitching and the greatest hitting from some of the best players in the game, when you show up, and remember that the proceeds from these all-star games go to indigent ball players.
On a country barn dance show, the rural announcer had a struggle with a French phrase and came out the loser in this manner.
We're going to hoop it up and you have a real dazzler. Charlie Docker will do the calling for the Paul Jones and food. Yes, sir, the best you ever ate. Right after the barn dance, the piece of ass resistance is fried chicken.
See a CBS special on marijuana. Get the habit. Stay tuned to this channel.
Announcers are human, too. And some of them, despite their professional training, can lose their perspective. Listen to what happened to this sports announcer who thought he had been cut off the air.
In the National League, the Cubs edged out Milwaukee 2-1. The Cards were taken by the Dodgers 6-4, behind the three-hit pitching of Don Newcomb. And, hey, you pulled out my AC power. You in the brown suit I'm supposed to be on the air, you pulled out my plug. Well, put the damn thing back in. You pulled out my AC, you baboon. Well, damn it, somebody did. Okay, all right. In tennis at Forest Hills, the national tennis doubles got underway this afternoon.
In Washington, the Senate is discussing the proposal to give federal funds to aid in research for the new supertonic transport. Now this word from Jerry Tall.
The heavens parted, and the voices rang clear to one and all. And then the angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
the time is now 6 a.m.
Microphone equipment is becoming smaller and less conspicuous. At a wrestling match, an announcer was busily describing the action in the ring when he was approached by a wrestling fan.
It's nice to see we got such a big crowd here tonight. It's a great turnout. We got some wonderful matches for you. Now, the main event of the evening is going to be 2 falls out of 3. Chief Bender is going to wrestle with Sandor Kovacs. Promises to be real exciting. But first, let's get a word in from our sponsor.
Hey, Mac, where's the can?
Continuing with our recorded memory lane, we hear two real old favorites. We'll spin this platter now with Only a Bird in a Gilded Cage on the front side, and I Wonder Who's Kissing Her Now on the backside.
Here is the case of an announcer who confused an earnest plea for savings bonds with a special health bulletin.
You owe it to yourself to invest in your future. Don't forget to buy government savings bonds. Help stamp out America.
Here is an incident that occurred on an audience participation program where the contestant should have left well enough alone.
All right, lady, now this is your chance to win $5 silver. Can you please tell me the meaning of the word octopus?
Let me see. I think I know. Octopus. Is that a fish on the bottom of the ocean? It has several testicles? Well, what are they all laughing at?
That's all right, lady. Don't feel so bad. You're not the only one to get that word all balled up.
Channel 5 asked one of the women's liberation picketers why they were protesting in front of the TV station.
The women's liberation group have been complaining that they are not being fairly treated by the broadcast media by being refused airtime to further their cause. Several disgruntled marchers decided to have their movement in the street.
NBC Moscow standing by for NBC New York. Are you there?
God damn, you beat your brains, you work like hell.
NBC Moscow. Standing by. Linia Mertvaya.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, well, I've been calling Moscow as well. I can't get anything out of them now either.
What makes me mad, you know what they say at the other end afterwards? New York has been... No, they tell New York that Moscow, the correspondent is not in. He does not accept the call. That's what... We've happened once before. I stayed here for 3 hours.
NBC Moscow, standing by.
Everything is normal. Like a bucket of shit is normal.
Aside from the high degree of surgical efficiency here at the Municipal Hospital, the student nurses are really something to see. Anybody would welcome a session in bed with one of these beautiful nurses.
Too many products can confuse an announcer. Here's a case in point.
Start your day right, Mother. Make your breakfast a hearty one and enjoy a truly tasty cup of coffee made from the finest South American tobacco.
Have you ever wondered what would happen to a radio performer if he developed hiccups during a broadcast? Let's listen to this commentator who had no choice but to carry on.
Membership of the United Nations is open to all peace-loving nations which accept the obligations of the United Nations Charter. The original members of the Security Council. Members is 60.
You have a drink of water.
No, thank you very much.
A well-known former jockey, now a sportscaster, came out with this description before a big race at the Hialeah racetrack.
One of the unusual sidelights in today's running of the Widener Handicap here at Hialeah concerns Rock Castle. It wasn't so long ago that this horse broke its leg, and it looked as if they were going to have to shoot the owner.
Bride and Groom is a program that tries to give newlywed couples all sorts of gifts to help their married life get off to a good start.
And as a final gift for your wedding, we have a wonderful surprise for you. This beautiful original Parisian wedding gown.
Oh, I already have my wedding gown. What I really need is a heavy-duty mattress.
There are some confusing words in this language of ours. For example, brazier, spelled B-R-A-Z-I-E-R, meaning a holder for hot coals. But that isn't the way this announcer saw it.
And the last memo, ladies, from your radio shopping service is a Father's Day reminder. It's barbecue time, and Schmidt's Hardware at 234 Main Street at the corner of Maple is featuring an ideal gift for Dad on his special day. An all-purpose brazier for delicious outdoor meals.
On a household safety program, this is what happened to an announcer and his doctor guest when a question had an unexpected answer.
What would you say is the most dangerous room in the house?
I should think either the bathroom or the kitchen.
Well, here's the surprise. According to a recent study, 1/4 of all accidents take place in the bedroom. The kitchen and the yard, where they still have yards, are next in order.
How do you account for the bedroom being such a dangerous place, Doctor?
Senator J. William Fulbright is now responding to questions about the Vietnam War raised by Senate Hawks.
As I said already, they have conducted themselves in the last 2 or 3 years much more discreet, with greater prudence and discretion than we have, because it is, I've forgotten what the question was.
He admitted that although he's traveled almost everywhere and played on almost every course, Sammy Snead had his greatest difficulty playing the Augusta Golf Course.
Television exercise programs are conducted in the wee hours of the morning when even the MC can be blurry-eyed.
And now, ladies, we're going to keep a trim waistline and do an exercise in which you stand perfectly straight with your feet spread apart. Fine. Well, ladies, I see our time is running out. We hope we'll see you tomorrow morning with the Stay Fit Career Girl Club. We'll see you at 6 a.m. tomorrow, and until then, remember, it's the early worm that gets the bird.
Here is an incident that happened in the early days of radio, resulting in hysteria at the expense of an unwitting and innocent contestant.
All right, young lady, it's your turn. What was the greatest surprise you ever had?
Gee, what a question. Let me think. Oh, yeah. The best surprise that I ever had was when my husband got out of the Army. I woke up one morning, and he was standing by my bed with his discharge in his hand.